Okay guys, here's a quick update on a couple projects. The LP640 project, we've got our fiberglass interior pieces. You can see the e-gear plate. That's a plate there for the radio bezel. We'll get that covered in carbon fiber. We've got the proper shape center console for the LP640, also the Reventon, whatever you want to call it. Is going to have the same console. These are actually the Reventon seats that are in the car, just for, I don't know, mock-up purposes, just to give you an idea of how everything comes together and fits. Got our first Reventon body today. Looks freaking awesome. So happy with the way this turned out. We're going to start these builds, two of them, we're starting next week. Nissan Maxima windshield fits right in that groove. No trimming required. This windshield on this car is all cracked and broken. That's what happens to these when you trim them. The Murcielago bodies, you have to trim these corners to get them to fit. And out of 10 times you trim them, one time it won't crack. And so this is just one that had cracked while we were trimming it. We're getting better at it, but seems like even after we trim them and everything is fine, it still can crack later on. If there's any little tiny chips in there that you don't even see, can carry over and gets cold and it cracks. So the Reventon will not require any trimming. So we're very happy about that. And you can see the quality of the fiberglass is phenomenal. And we're ecstatic about the way this thing turned out. So back to the interior on the LP640. We got these new door panels that turned out beautiful. There's the dash, center console, and we, like I said, we have the Reventon seats here. And the back side of the Reventon seats is the finished gel-coated side. The front is going to be padded and upholstered, so that's this unfinished rough side of the fiberglass for most parts. Like, this stuff is all, it looks like that underneath because you want your finished side out. But on a seat with the padding, the raw fiberglass is all padded out and not visible. The back side of the seat in some cases might be visible, so that's why we leave the nice gel coated side on the back. There's our V12 motor cover. A little bit of work to do yet on that to get some of the details in there, and we're going to carbon fiber the center piece that needs to be raised up a little bit in the middle and refitted, but that's kind of what we're starting with. Nice looking motor cover. That's about it. We're just doing our mock-up on the interior right now, getting it all fitted, and then we'll send it off to get upholstered, and we'll keep on moving along. Let me look at the Reventon body. Absolutely perfect the way this thing turned out. So we'll be documenting these builds and posting it on Mad Mechanics forum, and this body is so nice that I think we're going to be able to build this in a fraction of the time of a lot of the other cars that are out there. I'll keep posting more videos as we keep moving along. Thanks a lot for watching, guys.